I had to fight a lot of my insecurities because I've got like the flattest hair on this whole show this week. And so I've had to really, I had to be brave to even take my place and step up here. And, you know, I'm thinking, because I know all of you and we know our stories. And I know sometimes people look from the outside in and think, man, you know, they're just strong. Or people have often said to me, you know, you're obviously just strong or secure. And I think back, and I love what Jada said, everyone has said it, that, you know, the enemy's going to come after you at the areas that the Lord is most going to use you. And it's always a fight for your future. And I don't know that it ever stops throughout our whole life, but I remember, and he will use people you love. I remember my mom used to say, literally say the words to me, why can't you just be normal? Why can't you just be like every other Greek girl? Why do you want to read Christine instead of play with dolls? I remember literally once we were in Kmart and she wanted to buy me a Barbie doll. Now, which part of me looks like I'm going to play with Barbie dolls? But anyway, so I got a book and I was in the book section reading. And I remember I was like 5 years old. And my mum saying, Christine, no man is going to want to marry you. Now, remember, I'm 54, so this goes back a lot of years. No man's going to want to marry you if you are more intelligent than him. So why don't you be like the other girls play with dolls and stop reading? I mean, but I guess I'm trying to say to some of our viewers here where you go, you don't even realize how much you internalize things that are put on you from even well-meaning people that think they're doing good things for you. And as if I wasn't broken enough from so many things that had happened to me, but I've got to tell you, it took me decades. I'm not talking years, but decades before I started to understand the way God wired me up was actually for good, and that he would, obviously now we look at it and go, wow, look what Chris is doing. But the first several decades of my life were actually fighting all of those lies that I believed. And I was a bit like Moses, like, who am I? What could you do with me? I'm wired up all wrong, without realizing, I think, Jada, that actually God wired me up to do what he called me to do. But half of my life on this earth has been spent fighting those lies to get to where I needed to be. You know, we're talking about the younger generation, Laurie. I'm so glad you brought that up, because here's the deal. I got saved before there was an internet. I got saved and grounded in my spiritual formation before there was any social media.
Right?
And it was hard enough then. Mm-hmm. And then, it was even hard enough then to grow into who God called me to be. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I had people like Moses that you would look at, who says to the Lord, you know, who am I? Gideon, who said, my tribe is the least of the least, my clan. So throughout scripture, we see precedents of people that have struggled with their own limitations and the call of God and going, okay, I've got to step into it. Now, when you magnify that with social media and the internet, of course, I'm concerned about this generation. I've got an 18-year-old daughter, a 14-year-old daughter, so it's real. So some of the struggles, we've insecurity's been there from the outset of time, like we said, from the book of Genesis on, but it is magnified in this generation because I think of social media and the internet. So you'll need to listen to us. We're not just being big sisters and mamas. We're trying to save your life here. You have to learn to monitor how much social media you actually scroll through, how much you look at. And you listen, I have to do this with myself. I am not joking. 4 years ago, I literally unfollowed 150 people because I went, I'm done. I'm done with what this is doing to me, with some of the comparison games, what it's triggering in me that isn't right. And you know, I have a lot of followers. I have, and it was like, okay, this is going to, maybe some people are going to read this wrong or whatever, but I'm not, it's not about them. It's about what this is doing to me. And so in order for me to stay steadfast in the Word of God, believe the truth of God, I've got to minimize what I look at. It's not just me telling everyone else. I minimize what I focus on, what I look at, what I scroll through, what I read, what I listen to, what I watch. And so if you're wondering how people like us perhaps walk in confidence and strength, I've got to tell you, it's as much about what I don't look at, what I don't scroll, what I don't know, as much as what I do know. And I determined to know what the scripture says and what Jesus says about me, which means I don't know a whole lot about a lot of other stuff.
Hi everybody, I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe today and you'll never miss a new upload. Thanks for being a part of our Better Together community.